What's up, you low quality bitch?
Jesus, are you okay?
Well, I'm feeling pretty good. We kicked the shit out of the Blackhawks and beat them 6-1, and I did a shot for goal.
Yeah, that sounds great. I usually do the same thing.
Well, are you feeling?
Sober as a bird. Low quality fans of a high quality Bruins team that is not a dub, not right. Fuck, this was a really good game by the boys. It actually was. We just can't fucking finish, man. And the Islanders don't give up a lot. But we did play well. Look, I'm gonna mention these two now because it's weird to mention them in the middle. Eberle straight up missed an open net and it went off the post. And then later down the road, Varlamov made a huge save on Krejci with the inside of the paddle. Those two offset. This was supposed to be a tie game at the end. Well, I guess it would still have been a tie game had both of them gone in. This was a good game against a good team. Let's get into it. First of all, still no McKeg. I just want some Kegger because our fourth line has zero identity, and we're playing a team that has a fourth line known as the identity line. Also, DeBrusk, out. I don't think he should be out long term. In fact, I think he should be back in next game. I just want him to take one game off to just get the clouds out of there and figure it the fuck out, bud. Not like you're the only one, though. If there's any solace, you're not the only person on the team who can't find the back of the net. Looking at you, Charlie Coyle. Looking at you, Craig Smith. Looking at you, Studnika. I have a whole list. Should I do the whole thing? Looking at you, Krejci. No, I can't do the whole thing. Looking at you, Richie. Just kidding. Richie's actually scoring. Everybody else can't, but Richie is. Looking at you, Bjork. No Rask for this one. He's taking a break. He didn't even travel to the game. Totally agreed with that. If he has any issues, let Halak start. If we get blown up, put Vladar in again. I mentioned the identity line. Game starts. We start with our fourth line, which was interesting until they immediately give up a scoring chance. It's fine. We survived it. But throughout the first period, their Cizikas line dominated possession against our perfection line. I know a lot of us disagree with the perfection line nickname, and it feels like a curse. But it is what it is. They're one of the best lines in hockey, period. That is a blip on the game. Now, the perfection line did have some good stuff going in the second and third. The first period, they were completely hemmed in. It was bad, and it's foreboding. It is foreboding for a playoff series where that line can match up against our top line and do a okay job. The good news is we finally got a little bit of a monkey off our back. Our power play, we go to the PP, and you know what I say? A good PP is a clean PP, and it was. Coyle draws a penalty. It's tripping. We start the power play. We dominate possession, obviously, as we should, but we've seen that that doesn't always happen. We stay in their zone. Pasta at the top of the umbrella, because we're still doing that. Pasta at the top of the umbrella. Fucking annihilates the puck. It beats Varlamov low glove. The only reason this goes in is because Grizz sold a shot in which it was a shot, but it bounces to the corner. It gets fed back up to Pasta. When Grizz shot, Varlamov came way out to meet him on the left side. Puck misses, goes to the far right. Marshy collects, throws it to Pasta. Varlamov overcommits the other way, and then he almost got wrong-footed on this one. He comes back again, and Pasta aims low left foot, which is sliding to the left. I'm using different directions. You know what I mean. Goal for Pasta. 400th point, by the way. Exciting! I hate when milestones happen on nights we lose. But we go into the intermission with a 1-0 lead, so that's exciting against a team that we have not won a game against. 3 minutes in, Coyle gets called for a trip to make up for the fact that he drew a penalty earlier in the game. He wants to keep it nice and even. Doesn't matter. We kill it. We have one of the best periods of the season in this second period. Not for our team in general. I just mean as exciting as it can be. There's a lot of chances back and forth. They're not high danger. We know how the Islanders play. We know how we play. It's very, very interesting hockey, though. Passes are landing where they need to pass, and it's very clean. Not a lot of whistles. I love that kind of pace. We get another power play. Tenorti gets boarded. I can't deal with Pasta up at the point. I don't get it. I don't get it. I don't want it. I don't understand it. Someone, please give me a good reason why pasta should be at the point, especially when Grizz is almost all the way up on the blue line, as well as Marshy cheating on the upper half of the zone. We got three guys farther away from the goalie than they should be. Someone please give me a reason for this. Things take a little turn here. This might be an unpopular opinion. Cliffy loses an edge. It looks like Wahlstrom destroys him. He doesn't. He looks to finish a check. Doesn't expect Clifton to lose the edge. It was a weird bang-bang play. Maybe Wahlstrom could have slowed up a little bit. I don't think this was dirty or intentional. But Marshy jumps Wahlstrom immediately, which I'm fine with. It has a sad ending, but I'm fine with. Because Marchand is trying to make sure that people aren't taking liberties on the team because he's already seen it in the last week. Marshy gets called for roughing, which he should have. And unfortunately, the Isles capitalize. At the very end of the penalty, this was a play right out of our book, by the way. Nelson was in the Bergy spot in the bumper. It was a nice little feed to him. It was bang, 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 and Nelson just buries it past Halak. Halak, you'd love to see him attack that a little bit more. Power play goal, 1-1. We go to the third tide, and there's two things that piss me off about this. We go into the third, and it's not like our energy is missing, but we can't make a play. We can't hit take to take. I don't know what's happening. And then the second thing, .25 left in the game, tie game. Why is our fourth line out there?
I don't understand it. I don't understand it. Get your best guys out there. I don't want to see save it for overtime. I don't. Overtime's a crapshoot. We know it. Get your best guys out there.
Islanders have not won an overtime game in the last 8 overtimes they've had going back to last season. Lucky for them, it goes to a shootout. Now, there are a lot of chances back and forth in overtime, as you'd expect. A lot of miss in the net, too. No one can finish. And the shootout goes as follows. Eberle. Oh, just super speed. Flies down, beats Halak. It's a beauty. Good job by him. Pasta, the exact opposite approach. Eberle ended up beating Halak low glove. Pasta goes down almost same route, but wicked slow. Wicked fucking slow. And then just, bink, goal. Low glove. Barzal goes with a slow approach. He gets stuffed by Halak, who follows him the whole way. Coil, almost same thing. Goes kind of a slow approach. Goes 5-hole. Varley shuts the door. Two what should be good scorers. I don't know. Coil, are you a good scorer? And they both get stuffed. On to the third. Bevelier, dirty mitts. Tons of moves. Flies down. Halak doesn't really have a chance. He backhands it over him. Eventually, Halak was going to bite on something. Marshy's up next. Marshy just can't finish. And we lose the game in a shootout. That's now 4 losses to the Islanders. More importantly, way more importantly, in the past 5 games, we have allowed 5 goals. We've allowed 5 goals in the past 5 games. We have won 2 of those games. I figured it out, guys. I know what the problem with our team is. It's Tuukka! It's Tuukka's fault! Our defense has played really well, and they're injured heavily right now. I know everyone's jumping on the wagon of, we need a top sixer, we need a top sixer, or we need a top sixer. We already knew we needed a top 6 player. We already knew that. We knew that. Do we need it more than a top 4 left defenseman? There's an argument. There's an argument for that. But you know what I have also realized? Although we shut down teams really well, and although our top wingers are not performing as they should be, a defenseman who is strong on the puck and can make an outlet pass would do so well for us. Would do so well. We have McAvoy and Grizz who can do that. But the other 4 guys cannot. Zaboral at times has shown flashes. Vakanainen too, actually. But I still think a defenseman would benefit us. But I'm starting to creep to the other side. I don't know. I am teetering on the edge right now. I know a lot of people have jumped already, but I'm teetering. Game notes. Trent Frederick looks like a legitimate NHL player. He is making legitimate plays. His head is up way more. I mean, if you watch, do me a favor. God, please, Freddie, don't fuck me on this. Do me a favor. Spend some time not watching the puck and just watch a couple players. Pick out Freddie, pick out Vok, pick out Stud. And you're noticing, Stud still too small. Vox still too small. They get bullied at times. Fred doesn't get bullied. Head up way more than we saw early in the season. And he is making legitimate NHL plays. Nice passes. Nice IQ. He could have the potential. And it's not happening this year. It's a long road to get here. He's got to be one of those slow growth guys.
This guy could end up on our top six someday. He's got some mitts, man, and he's got some IQ. And I think his skating's catching up and his confidence is catching up. Keep an eye on this one. Zaboral's getting more comfortable. I've really enjoyed him when he joins the rush. We'll see if that advances. On the negative, the Islanders feel literally impossible to score against. They feel so difficult to score against. If we have a series against them in the playoffs, we need to get all the calls. By the way, we got away with so much shit in that third period. We had so many missed calls that could have gone against us and obliterated us in that third period. We are lucky to have gotten out of there with a point. 6 minutes left of the third period. I realized no matter how this game ends, I'm going to be disappointed. If you look at our stats and you look at our wins, losses, there's some dumb losses, and then there's losses to the Islanders, and then every other team, we're kind of like, we can beat the shit out of you. The Caps are not as frightening as they used to be. The Flyers, well, we're 5-0 against them. Pittsburgh, we haven't played them a lot, but we haven't lost to them. But this had to be a regulation win, and it had to be a win by 2 goals for me to be happy. I'm not fucking happy. This coaching staff is not in danger. The seat has warmed, as I said in the last episode. They're not in danger. Sweeney will outlast this coaching staff. That's obvious. The coaches are hired to be fired. The GM, it takes a monumental collapse for a GM to be fired. This is what I need for next game. I need McKeg. He is a legitimate energy guy. We need him on the fourth line. We need to start creating a identity. We need one on that fourth line. I need DeBrusque back in. I just want to see if he's going to react as we need him to. I need Bjork to stick around. His penalty killing, awesome. I like his energy. I think he's doing well. And I have one challenge for Charlie Coyle. Shoot the fucking puck. Zero attempts this last game. Bro, could we get 4 attempts next game? 4. I don't care where the fuck you're shooting from. I can't give a flying shit. Shoot the puck, because I know you're capable of scoring goals. Stop caring so much about your wingers. Play your game. You are good enough to carry a line. Fucking act like it. We're going to go on a winning streak. This is a good team. We are going to go on a winning streak. Fuck, I just hope it's soon, man, because we are running out of time. All right, everybody. That does it for me. Like and subscribe, please, if you made it this far.
I mean, I'm at 89 subscribers. We're 11 away from the season's goal. That's pretty neat.
But seriously, just watching the videos, guys, I appreciate it. I've talked to some awesome people through this. The people who comment every week, I love that. And I read the comments. I know I don't always respond, but I read the comments. I really enjoy it. It pumps me up for the next episode. This has been awesome, and I appreciate it.